सर।
परफेक्ट। सो टुडे वी विल स्टार्ट विथ वीएलएसआई डिवाइसेस एंड वी विल स्टार्ट विथ व्हाट इज कॉल्ड एज अ मॉस कैपेसिटेंस। सो व्हाट डू यू अंडरस्टैंड बाय द टर्म मॉस?
मेटल ऑक्साइड सेमीकंडक्टर।
ओके, मेटल ऑक्साइड एंड सेमीकंडक्टर, एंड व्हाई इज इट अ कैपेसिटेंस?
सर बिकॉज इट इज फॉर्मिंग डिफरेंट डिफरेंट मोड इट वर्क्स ऑन। जैसे अक्यूमुलेशन में काम कर रहा है तो फिर सर चार्ज इफ यू आर टेकिंग अ पी टाइप सबस्ट्रेट सपोज, सो ऑन द सेमीकंडक्टर ऑक्साइड लेयर वी आर हैविंग देयर आर पॉजिटिव चार्जेस एंड इफ यू आर अप्लाइंग द नेगेटिव वोल्टेज ऑन मेटल सर्फेस, सो इट इज मेटल मेटल प्लेट इज एग्जिस्टिंग लाइक अ नेगेटिव प्लेट, सो इट जस्ट बिहेविंग लाइक अ कैपेसिटेंस एंड इन बिटवीन वी आर हैविंग एन ऑक्साइड ऑफ which is just behaving like dielectric.
Yeah, so what we have is when we say it is a metal oxide semiconductor, then what we are essentially looking at it is a structure where we have one plate, the second plate, which is a silicon body, and then a dielectric separating the two. Okay, so that is what is a MOS capacitor. And how is it different from a MOS transistor? Just that a MOS transistor would also have a source and a drain there, which a MOS capacitor doesn't have. So we will first look at MOS capacitors. We will come to MOS transistors a little later. Okay. So what I've done over here is I've just rotated the metal oxide semiconductor in a different way, by 90 degrees, so that we could look at what we call as energy band diagram. I believe all of you are aware of this.
Yes, sir.
Anyone who has not seen band diagrams earlier?
Sir, I haven't seen in this form. So, like, I know the very basic one which is taught to us in school, but not of this complexity.
Yeah, so we understand that there is a band diagram. That much you know. That is what was taught in
Yes.
physics in class 11th and 12th.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yeah, that is all that we need for now. Okay. Anyways, this is not a course on solid state devices, so I will not go into too much detail. But what we do understand is that there is a conduction band and there is a valence band. This much you know.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
And then we also know that there is a, okay, so in between them, there is a Fermi, there is an intrinsic level, EI. And then there is something called as Fermi level, EF. So just Fermi level pata hai, say to aapko?
No, sir, I haven't heard that term before.
Okay, so Fermi level is a notional level, so it is not a physical vacancy where an electron can be, nothing like that. Fermi level is a notional level where the probability of finding an electron is 50%. In a p-type semiconductor, the Fermi level is close to the valence band because you know that there are more p-types, there are more holes, so electrons will most probably be in one of the valence band places itself. Okay, and in n-type semiconductors, because we have doped the semiconductor n-type, there are more electrons, and ES shifts closer to the conduction band. Okay, it has no notional value except the fact that it is a probability that, or at this energy level, you will have 50% of your electrons. Okay, in reality, at EF there is zero electron. In reality, at EF there is zero electron, but considering the Fermi Dirac distribution, we say that there is some Fermi level there. Okay. If the Fermi level is very close to the valence band, we say that holes, electrons can very quickly jump into the Fermi level and from the Fermi level back to the valence band, and therefore there can be lots of vacancies or holes over here which will cause conduction. Okay, while on the other level, if if we have the Fermi level close to the conduction band, let us say over here, then we say that there are lots of electrons at the Fermi level which can jump into the conduction band as and when needed. Okay, and therefore you will have conduction that is done through electrons. Is this thing clear, the concept of Fermi level? Again, the idea is not to say that आपको Fermi level पूरा पता होना चाहिए, but intuitive understanding is there.
Yes, sir. I mean, just one more thing, sir. What was EI again? I forgot.
I'm sorry.
What was EI representing? EI.
EI is the intrinsic level where again you do not actually find any electron, but if there is intrinsic silicon where there is no doping, then you say that. Then you show that the probability of finding an electron is 50% in the conduction band and 50% in the valence band.
Okay.
So therefore, it is called as EI.
Okay. Thank you.
Sir, this energy band diagram is for depletion mode, na?
We will come to that. अभी आएंगे उसपे. ठीक है? So now, whenever you have whenever you bring different materials together, one has to realize that Fermi level will remain constant. Okay, so this region represents p-type silicon body. Okay, this region represents the metal gate. And this region represents the oxide, the dielectric. Do you realize how big the band gap of the oxide is? It's 9 electron volts. That is where it is a dielectric. Ek electron chaha ke bhi 9 electron volts wali energy nahi la sakta to get into the conduction band and therefore conduct any charge through it. Okay? So the gap between the edge of any material, any two materials, always remains constant. Okay, in the sense that if you have a dielectric with a electron affinity of, so electron affinity ka concept yaad hai aapko school se?
Yes sir, yes sir.
Okay, so electron affinity is that if this is vacuum level, then electron affinity of this is chi, this is you may say chi bar, whatever. Okay, chi b, whatever, kuch bhi naam de do. So they have different electron affinity, but at their interface we know that in dono ki electron affinity mein 3.1 electron volts ka difference hai. So at their interface they will always, oxide and silicon will always interact with 3.1 electron volts. Okay, now over here we have n plus polysilicon, again on the other side also we have 3.1 electron volts. Now as you want to match the Fermi levels, humne kaha ki Fermi level is the energy level jahan pe koi bhi electron find karne ki probability is 50%, then what happens is that this 3.1 electron volts and this 3.1 electron volts leads to some voltage drop across the oxide and some voltage drop across the semiconductors, that is silicon also. This, the voltage drop, this is represented by a gradation in the valence band, the conduction band over here, and the bending of bands in the silicon. This band bending results in change in concentration of charges close to the gate dielectric. So any questions till now? Hello?
No, sir.
It is all clear to everyone?
Yes, sir. When sir, in this case, we have not applied any voltage. So, sir, what does change in charges near the outside interface mean?
Because we said that the Fermi level has to be matched. Let me just erase all of this. See, we said that in any material, the probability of finding an electron at Fermi level is 50%. So now this is a composite material, which includes a metal oxide and a semiconductor. So in this composite material, the Fermi level has to match across the entire material. Okay. Now we know that this is a p-type semiconductor, p-type silicon body as said. Therefore, Fermi level is close to the valence band. On the other side, we know it is n plus type silicon, so Fermi level and conduction band are almost overlapping. Okay, so this is what we know. Now what happens is that since there is this is a semiconductor, it cannot really bring in as many electrons as possible. There is some doping constraint, some availability of electrons, which is limited. Therefore, when the Fermi level has to be maintained the same and a 3.1 electron volt gap has to be maintained between the conduction band of oxide and semiconductor, there is a requirement to bend the energy bands. You have not applied any voltage, but some band bending is already happening. What does this mean? That, see, in this region, in this region, had there been no oxide or had there been no metal on this side, what would have happened? My bands would have continued to look like this. Am I right? Had there been no oxide, my bands would have been straight. Now, since this 3.1 electron volt rule has to be met, come whatever may, my bands bend. What this means is that while in this region, my semiconductor is actually n-type, over here in this region, in this region it is p-type, in this region close to the oxide, it starts to become either intrinsic type or n-type, because Fermi level starts to come closer to the conduction band. So are you able to see this? That just I have brought three materials together, and at the surface of the semiconductor, there is some band bending leading to some change in the properties of the semiconductor.
Excuse me, sir, why does it need to be happen that my Fermi level is maintained across the device?
Because Fermi level is a mathematical term. It says that it is the probability of finding an electron at this energy level is 50%.
So, I mean, couldn't I say that the probability of finding electron at 50% is different at different materials?
No.
Okay.
Fermi level ka definition hi hai ki wo constant hai aapke pure material mein.
Okay, thank you.
Okay. Yes, Akshat.
Sir, in case of metal, the Fermi level and conduction band are coinciding.
In case of N plus silicon, it is coinciding simply because we say that N plus ki wajah se itna sara electrons wahan pe ho gaya hai that Fermi level is within a few electron volt, a few milli electron volts of the conduction band. So you've made them overlapping. It is
sir,
a very highly doped. It's called as degenerated semiconductor. Very high doping. Okay, so when you will do the solid state devices course,
sir?
You will study this in much more detail.
Hello.
Yes.
सर जहाँ आपने सर्कल किया है मिडल में वहां पर ही वैसा होगा ना कि वो इंट्रिंसिक टाइप या एंड टाइप की तरह बिहेव करेगा,
हाँ
क्योंकि
ओनली
क्योंकि
क्लोजेस्ट ऑफ
मेरा वो बैंड
आइडेंटिफायर.
बहुत नियर है ईएफ के, मतलब जहां
यस
पे आपने स्मॉल. ओके ओके
यस 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 बिकॉज बिकॉज इट इज ओनली एट द इंटरफेस. ओके
थैंक यू सर.
सो अगर अगर मैं ये कहता कि इस तरफ अगर मैं ये कहता कि मेरा जो पीमॉस था, ये जो पीमॉस कह रहा हूं, जो पी टाइप सेमीकंडक्टर था वो इतना ज्यादा डोप्ड नहीं था, तो दिस दिस ईवी वुड हैव बीन स्टिल लोअर एंड ईसी वुड हैव बीन लाइक दिस एंड आई माइट हैव एक्चुअली हैव अ एन टाइप मटेरियल, एन टाइप सेमीकंडक्टर बिहेवियर एट द ऑक्साइड. अगर एक पी टाइप मटेरियल एन टाइप की तरह बिहेव करने लगे, व्हाट डू वी से?
इन्वर्जन, स्ट्रॉन्ग इन्वर्जन.
वी से इट स्टार्टेड टू इट इज एन इन्वर्जन. व्हाट स्ट्रॉन्ग इन्वर्जन इज, वी विल कम टू अ लिटिल लेटर, बट वी से इट इज गॉट इन्वर्टेड. वी हैड अ पी टाइप मटेरियल, इट इज नाउ कन्वर्टेड इनटू अ एन टाइप मटेरियल. सो इन्वर्जन हैज स्टार्टेड टू हैपन. And what we are saying is that by choosing the electron affinity of the gate material, I can change the band bending on the semiconductor side. Yes, there was a question.
To happen that band bending, we have to apply voltage across MOSFET, right?
I'm sorry, can you please repeat, Guruvir?
Sir, what I am saying is, near the interface of silicon and silicon dioxide, I mean P-type substrate and silicon dioxide, there is a band bending, right?
Yes.
And at that place, the P substrate is converted to intrinsic and then to N-type.
Yes, depending on the electron affinity of the gate material.
Yeah, but for all this to happen, we have to apply with bias, right? I mean, we have to apply voltage across the mass gap.
No, no, no. Abhi humne, we have not done anything like that.
Sir, if we apply the voltage on the metal surface, na, then only if positive voltage is applied, then only it comes into the depletion mode and then after inversion. But if when we are not applying any voltage, then sir, it is a flat band only.
No, that is what I am correcting your understanding.
Sir,
that is the purpose of this discussion.
Sir, तो अगर voltage apply नहीं किया तो वहाँ पे charges कैसे invert हो रहे, like charges move ही नहीं करेंगे फिर?
करेंगे ना, यही तो मैं कह रहा हूँ, because there is this Fermi level that has to be maintained. See, there are two things that
Fermi level. Sir, Fermi level तो maintain रहेगा ना, like यहाँ पे current flow नहीं हो रहा तो Fermi level तो वहीं पे रहेगा ना सर, Fermi level change होगा ही नहीं.
हाँ, so Fermi level maintain करना आपने एक rule ये ही है. दूसरा रूल ये है कि आपको इलेक्ट्रॉन एफिनिटी वाला जो गैप है वो मेंटेन करना है. इन दोनों रूल्स को आप जो ही फॉलो करोगे, आपको दिखेगा दैट एट द सरफेस देर हैज टू बी सम बैंड बेंडिंग, देर इज नो अदर वे.
एक्चुअली सर मुझे जहां तक पता है, लाइक बैंड बेंडिंग तब तभी होता है जब कि वहां पे चार्जेस लाइक अगर डाउनवर्ड्स बेंड हो रहा है, वहां पे इलेक्ट्रॉन आ रहे हैं नियर द सिलिकॉन ऑक्साइड.
हाँ, क्योंकि ये बेंड हो रहा है, मैं तो ऑलरेडी कह रहा हूँ, मैं भी तो यही कह रहा हूँ दैट द मटेरियल हैज गॉट इन्वर्टेड देयर. व्हाट एम आई सेइंग?
तो सर जब
एम आई सेइंग एनीथिंग डिफरेंट?
वोल्टेज अप्लाई नहीं की सर, जो जब तक वोल्टेज नहीं अप्लाई किए तो वहां पे सिलिकॉन डाइऑक्साइड की लेयर के पास इलेक्ट्रॉन आएंगे नहीं वहां पे, तो
क्यों नहीं आएंगे? हेलो हेलो, क्यों नहीं आएंगे? देयर इज अ ह्यूज अवेलेबिलिटी ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन्स इन दिस रीजन.
सर
इतना बड़ा सॉलिड सिलिकॉन
है ना सर, वो तो वहां पे सर इलेक्ट्रॉन्स कम होंगे ना, लाइक
कम होंगे लेकिन आ जाएंगे
सर. बट बैंड बेंडिंग तो तभी होगी ना जब कोई इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड एग्जिस्ट कर रही होगी, जब इलेक्ट्रिक
ये कर रहा है ना, ये कर रहा है ना इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड. देयर इज दिस बैंड बेंडिंग हैपनिंग. बैंड बेंडिंग हैपनिंग मींस इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड एग्जिस्ट.
सर इलेक्ट्रिकली न्यूट्रल होगा ना सर, वहां पे तो कोई इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड होगी नहीं पी सबस्ट्रेट में, अगर कुछ पोटेंशियल अप्लाई
नहीं है. देखो यहाँ पे नहीं है, इस एरिया में नहीं है
सर. नियर द जंक्शन कैसे इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड आ रही है आपकी कहने से?
अच्छा चलो छोड़ो, अच्छा छोड़ो, इसको छोड़ देते हैं. आप एक पी टाइप मटेरियल और एक एन टाइप मटेरियल साथ लेकर आते हो.
यस सर.
आप एक पी टाइप मटेरियल और एक एन टाइप मटेरियल साथ लेकर आते हो, आप कहते हो पीएन जंक्शन बन गया.
यस सर.
आपने कोई वोल्टेज नहीं लगाई लेकिन बैंड
नो
बेंडिंग हो
सर,
रही होती है ना?
वहां पे चार्जेस क्या बोलते हैं, चार्जेस लेयर फॉर्म हो जाती है, इमोबाइल चार्जेस
तो यहाँ भी वही हो रहा है, यहाँ के जो होल्स थे दे रहा है ना अवे फ्रॉम द सरफेस।
सर। अभी तो सिलिकॉन डाइऑक्साइड तो कुछ कर नहीं पाएगा, लाइक सबस्ट्रेट अपना प्योर है अभी वहां पे नियर द जंक्शन,
हाँ बट द
वहां पे
इलेक्ट्रॉन्स रैन अवे, इलेक्ट्रॉन्स रैन अवे।
जैसे जो यूनिफॉर्मिटी फॉर्म है पहले से वही अभी भी फॉर्म रहेगी, लाइक अभी जब तक वोल्टेज नहीं लगा रहे, ये मैं कहना चाहता हूँ।
तो वोल्टेज नहीं लगा रहे का मतलब क्या है? हमने देखो कुछ ना कुछ इलेक्ट्रोड तो लगाया, तभी तो हम मेजर कर रहे हैं ना कुछ। अगर यहाँ पे आपने तीन मटेरियल्स को साथ लेकर आए और आपने कुछ भी उस मटेरियल, आपने उस सिलिकॉन के साथ कुछ भी टच कर दिया, आपने उसको फिंगर से ही टच कर दिया, वो चार्ज आपके फिंगर में आ जाएगा।
सर ये जो सिलिकॉन डाइऑक्साइड के ट्रैप चार्ज है इनके कारण ये फ्लैट बेंडिंग हो
नो
रही है क्या?
नो 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 नथिंग ऑफ दैट सॉर्ट। मैंने तो ट्रैप
सर
चार्जेस की बात ही नहीं करी।
मींस ये
सर
SiO2 आइडियल आइडियल है, देयर इज नो
बैंड बेंडिंग,
ट्रैप
खाली
चार्जेस।
बैंड बेंडिंग इज हैपनिंग ओनली बिकॉज देर इज अ कॉन्स्टेंट फर्मी, देर आर टू रूल्स, देर इज अ कॉन्स्टेंट फर्मी लेवल एंड द अदर रूल इज दैट द इलेक्ट्रॉन एफिनिटी हैज टू बी सेम। सो इलेक्ट्रॉन एफिनिटी हैज टू बी सेम, इट मीन्स देर विल बी बैंड बेंडिंग, there is no other way because some electric field will drop, some built-in voltage will drop across the oxide and the remaining built-in voltage would drop across the silicon. See, look at it like this, aap ek n-type aur ek p-type material ko saath lekar aaye, is case mein aapne bas unke beech mein ek oxide dal diya. Had I brought them exactly together, then the band bending would have been more. Now the band bending is slightly lesser because oxide also has some voltage drop across it.
Sir?
Yes.
So why electron affinity has to remain the same across the interface?
Because just because I'm bringing say aluminium and copper together does not mean that they will now behave differently as metals, or just because I'm bringing carbon and silicon together it doesn't mean that they will now behave, the electrons will start to behave differently in these two materials. Electron
okay.
affinity will remain same, the materials are materials.
Yes sir. Okay sir.
Sir
okay
sir.
Yes.
Sir, can I draw an inference that sir, there are two types of devices, sir, depletion type MOSFET and enhancement type MOSFET. So sir, if the EC band.
अभी हम MOSFET पे तो पहुंचे ही नहीं है अक्षत, अभी तो हम खाली MOS पे हैं। FET की तो बात ही नहीं आई अभी। अभी
sir?
तो खाली मैं ये कह रहा हूँ कि मेटल ऑक्साइड और सेमीकंडक्टर को जब साथ साथ लाओगे तो ऑलरेडी कुछ बैंड बेंडिंग हो जाएगी। अभी तो मैंने खाली ये कॉन्सेप्ट इंट्रोड्यूस करा है
सर।
यस
मुझे ये वाला लॉजिक आ गया कि वो जो मेन प्रॉब्लम आ रही है वो सेकंड जो आपने पॉइंट बोला है इलेक्ट्रॉन एफिनिटी मेंटेन करने से लॉजिक समझ में आ गया सर बैंडिंग का। पर अगर हम बोलते हैं कि हर मेटल की इलेक्ट्रॉनिक एफिनिटी अलग अलग होती है ना, हर एलिमेंट की, तो सर जब हम उसको साथ में ला के जब एक ऐसा ऐसा एक फॉर्म कर रहे हैं जंक्शन टाइप बीच में ऐसा मतलब ऑक्साइड लगा के, तो ऐसा क्या हो रहा है कि वो पूरा एज अ होल बल्क या होल मटेरियल की इलेक्ट्रॉनिक एफिनिटी से सेम इलेक्ट्रॉन एफिनिटी सेम हो जा रही है, ऐसा क्यों हो रहा है?
नहीं, इलेक्ट्रॉन एफिनिटी कहाँ सेम हो जा रही है, हमने कहा कि जब दो मटेरियल साथ में आएंगे तो जो उनका डिफरेंस इन इलेक्ट्रॉन एफिनिटी है वो मेंटेन रहेगा।
अच्छा, मतलब उनकी इंडिविजुअल वैल्यूज तो अलग अलग रहेंगी लेकिन जो गैप होगा वो सेम रहना चाहिए,
वो तो सेम रहेगा।
अच्छा ओके,
है ना?
ओके सर।
यस सेतु,
I just wanted to clarify one thing. So this 3.1 electron volt is because of this difference in electron affinity, right?
Electron affinity of silicon dioxide and silicon.
Okay. So the polysilicon or the p-type silicon? Actually, I'm
Any,
still a bit confused.
So electron affinity is always from the conduction band. इट डज नॉट डिपेंड ऑन आपका पी टाइप सिलिकॉन, पी टाइप सिलिकॉन, एन टाइप सिलिकॉन तो फर्मी फर्मी बैंड के फर्मी लेवल के साथ डिफाइन होगा ना, कंडक्शन
नो नो
बैंड तो
स्टॉप
हमेशा वही रहने वाला है।
सो आई वाज टॉकिंग अबाउट दिस एन प्लस पॉलीसिलिकॉन और पी
इधर
और
भी
पी सिलिकॉन मॉडल
बोथ साइड सी बोथ साइड आई हैव रिटन
ओके
3.1 इलेक्ट्रॉन वोल्ट्स।
एंड सो
व्हेनेवर देयर
बाय
इज सिलिकॉन,
सो
सिलिकॉन टू सिलिकॉन डाइऑक्साइड इज 3.1 इलेक्ट्रॉन वोल्ट्स।
So why is this? Because I mean, since I have doped it, so I mean, I assume it should affect it somehow. And why isn't it affecting the affinity?
No. So, because the material is silicon, the conduction band. See, आप doping doping कितना कर रहे हो? The even after doping, your impurity is 0.009% something.
Yes, sir.
So, इतना कम doping will not change your electron affinity. इलेक्ट्रॉन एफिनिटी वुड पॉसिबली चेंज अगर आप अलॉय बनाओगे, या अलॉय में भी यू नो अलग अलग मटेरियल्स का अलग होगा, बट क्योंकि आप दोनों मटेरियल्स को अलग अलग देख ही नहीं पा रहे, आप एज्यूम कर लोगे कि हो गया। एट एन इम्प्योरिटी लेवल ऑफ सच लो क्वांटिटीज वॉट एवर यू मे डोप, इवन देन द डोपिंग इज वेरी वेरी मिनिस्क्यूल, इट इज स्टिल एन इम्प्योरिटी, इट इज देयरफॉर कॉल्ड एन इम्प्योरिटी, इट इज नॉट कॉल्ड एन अलॉय, है ना?
ओके,
सो इट स्टिल रिमेन्स फॉलोज द सिलिकन थिंग। ओके
सर,
यस
सर, जो 3.1 इलेक्ट्रॉन वोल्ट है, ये क्या सिर्फ इंटरफेस पे ही फॉलो हो पाएगा क्या? मतलब
मतलब इसका इधर वाले मतलब सो इस पॉइंट
हाँ,
का इधर वाले पॉइंट से कोई रिलेशनशिप है ही नहीं, दे आर नॉट इन टच।
हाँ मतलब, और हाँ तो वहां पे नहीं रहेगा ना, मतलब ऐसा कुछ
नहीं
हम सिर्फ
नहीं
इंटरफेस पे ही देख रहे हैं।
यस Wherever they are in touch, that is where you have to ensure that 3.1 electron volts is the gap there.
So just one more thing. So basically, so what I'm able to understand from the diagram is that the reason we are bending is because there's a gap between the point at which I'm measuring my EF, which has to be maintained across the device, and this teeny tiny line, which is from which I'm measuring the 3.1 electron volt on the right side.
Yes.
That is precisely the, and like if that gap increases, then I have to bend more. If that decreases, then I have to bend less, right?
Yes.
And so, what does this gap exactly depend on? Can you please tell me?
This gap? Gap between Fermi level and
yeah.
valence band or conduction band?
No. Between Fermi level and the lower point from which I'm measuring 3.1 electron volt on the right side. So I guess you marked it as EI.
No, no. So, okay. So, Fermi level for a semiconductor is defined by the doping density in that Fermi level, in that material.
Okay.
Okay. So, Fermi, अगर आपका ये आपका EC और EV है, और आप बहुत ज्यादा पी टाइप डोपिंग कर रहे हो, तो आपका फर्मी लेवल बिल्कुल ईवी के साथ मर्ज सा होगा। अगर आप
yes,
कम
sir.
करोगे तो ये हल्का सा ऊपर होगा, अगर आप एन टाइप डोपिंग करोगे तो ये और ऊपर होगा, और जब आप एन प्लस टाइप कर दोगे, डीजनरेट कर दोगे, तो ये ईसी के साथ काइंड ऑफ मर्ज हो जाएगा, जैसा यहाँ पे दिखाया भी हुआ है। ओके, सो द डोपिंग विल डिफाइन हाउ फार योर फर्मी लेवल इज फ्रॉम योर कंडक्शन बैंड और द वैलेंस बैंड। ओके,
okay,
now
sir,
this Fermi level is constant, and you know that these 3.1 electron volts and this 3.1 electron volt has to be maintained. To be able to maintain this, I have to drop. So agar Fermi level maintained rakhna hai aur 3.1 electron volt rakhna hai, I have to somewhere drop the gap between EC and EF across the oxide and the semiconductor.
Okay.
Now, the dielectric constant of the oxide is three times the dielectric constant of, so ESIO, so three times ESI is equal to epsilon of SiO2.
11.7 and 3.1.
Yeah. ठीक है, तो क्योंकि जो ऑक्साइड है उसका डायलैक्ट्रिक कॉन्स्टेंट ज्यादा है, देर विल बी मोर बेंडिंग इन द ऑक्साइड, and there will be lesser bending in the silicon. So आपने यहां से एक EG निकाला, समझ लो एनर्जी गैप ईजी निकाला। अब ईजी जो है, ये जो ईजी वोल्टेज है वो कैसे डिस्ट्रीब्यूट होगी ऑक्साइड में और सिलिकन में, दैट विल फॉलो दिस फॉर्मूला कि सिलिकन डाइऑक्साइड पे 3 times एक्स्ट्रा बेंडिंग होगी।
ओके
नाउ व्हाट दैट मींस इज आपको पता लग गया कि आपके सेमीकंडक्टर साइड पे कितनी बेंडिंग होनी है, एंड यू कैन एक्चुअली प्रीएम्प्ट कि अगर मैंने गेट को इस तरह से डोप कर रखा है या गेट पे इस इलेक्ट्रॉन एफिनिटी का मटेरियल लगा रखा है तो मेरी कितनी बैंड बेंडिंग जस्ट बिकॉज ऑफ दैट गेट मटेरियल ऑटोमेटिकली हो जाएगी। ठीक है, व्हाई एम आई टेलिंग यू ऑल दिस इन अ डीवीडी कोर्स, आई डोंट नीड टू टॉक अबाउट ऑल दिस एट ऑल, बट आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट ऑल दिस बिकॉज व्हाट हैपेंस इज टुडे व्हेन यू गो टू द इंडस्ट्री दे विल टॉक अबाउट हाई के मेटल गेट डाइलेक्ट्रिक, हाई के मेटल गेट टेक्नोलॉजीज। What does high K metal gate mean? That instead of oxide, they are using a high K material, a material which has a dielectric constant, which is, you know, say 9 times of SiO, silicon. Okay, I don't know what exactly it is, but yeah, something like that. And on the other side, to be able to control the band bending on the silicon side, they are using metal gates with different affinity so that after the band bending happens you still have a device which you wanted. This is called as gate engineering.
So if I understand what you're saying, that if I already start up with some offset, then I don't have to bend as much as I have to bend in this case.
Yes. But okay, to control the VT of the device, you may actually want some bending already to be there.
Okay, thank you.
Sir, हम metal पे flat bending voltage apply करके ये bend इनको bend को flat नहीं कर सकते क्या?
कर सकते हैं। अगर आपको इधर flat करना है, तो आप क्या करोगे? Metal के ऊपर इस तरफ एक voltage लगाओगे जो इसको ऊपर ले जाए। जो ही वो इस साइड को ऊपर लेके जाएगा, ये साइड भी ऊपर चली जाएगी, यहाँ पे भी फ्लैट हो जाएगा सब कुछ। सो दैट इज वेयर फॉर अ ट्रांजिस्टर देयर इज अ डिफरेंट वोल्टेज व्हिच इज कॉल्ड एज फ्लैट बैंड वोल्टेज, एंड फ्लैट बैंड वोल्टेज इज रेयरली जीरो। ओके, सो एट फ्लैट बैंड वोल्टेज देयर इज नो चार्ज at no special charge at the interface of oxide and silicon.
Okay.
आगे बढ़े
सर।
यस
सर, ये जो ग्रेडियंट है विच इज कनेक्टिंग द टू कंडक्शन बैंड ऑफ एन टाइप सिलिकन एंड पी टाइप सिलिकन, सर दिस इज जस्ट शोइंग की बैंड बेंडिंग हुई है ना? That
yes,
straight line
and that band bending is in this ratio. The ratio of the dielectric constants. Okay.
Okay, sir.
आगे बढ़े आप।
सर ये ऊपर शायद आपने बाय मिस्टेकली गलत लिख दिया। एप्सिलॉन फॉर SI इज इक्वल टू 3 times ऑफ एप्सिलॉन ऑफ SiO2 होना चाहिए ना?
सॉरी एप्सिलॉन, हाँ SiO2 का डायलेक्ट्रिक कांस्टेंट 3 times SI है ना?
हाँ सर, आपने 3 times ऑफ SI इक्वल टू SiO2 लिखा हुआ है। सर सिलिकॉन ऑक्साइड का जो एप्सिलॉन होता है वो 3.9 होता है और सिलिकॉन का 11.7 होता है।
हाँ सॉरी ठीक है
यस सर,
आगे बढ़े।
यस सर,
सो अब हमने कहा कि जो ही मैंने यस
सर, दैट बैंड बेंडिंग इज नथिंग बट द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ चैनल राइट? या आई मीन मॉस्फेट।
सो वी आर नॉट इवन टॉकिंग अबाउट मॉस्फेट येट, वी आर ओनली टॉकिंग अबाउट अ मॉस। सो देयर इज नो चैनल येट बिकॉज़ अ चैनल विल कम व्हेन आई हैव अ सोर्स एंड अ ड्रेन। इन दिस पर्टिकुलर फिगर देयर इज नो सोर्स नो ड्रेन, दिस इज ओनली अ गेट।
Yes, sir. But the same concept is used in MOSFET, right?
Yeah, when we will come to MOSFET, we will use the same concept. Yes.
Okay, sir.
Okay. Yeah. So, going forward, we say that what we are saying then is that when we now since there is some band bending already happening, what we are saying is that when we will apply some voltage between the gate and the body, there will be charge that will deposit or that will accumulate at the two plates. So for any time, you know, I have two plates and I apply some delta V. So delta Q happens here and delta Q happens here, the two sides of the plate. Am I right? So capacitance, agar mujhe nikalna hai, how do I find the capacitance? I say that capacitance is equal to delta Q by delta V. Are you with me on this? When I apply a delta V, there is some charge that will get formed at the two plates. And my capacitance is delta Q by delta V. And I also know that this capacitance is equal to basically area of the plates and the distance between them. No, sorry.
A epsilon naught upon D.
Epsilon A upon D. Am I right? Epsilon A upon D,
yes,
the distance between the two plates. Now, if the plates, if I increase the distance between the plates, what would happen to my capacitance?
Decrease.
If I bring my plates together, what happens?
Increases.
The capacitance would increase. Okay.
Increase.
Yeah. So we will use this concept in our next slide. So what happens is that there are multiple regions in which I can operate the MOS capacitor. I can operate it in what we call as an accumulation region, where I will have many more holes at the surface. So agar hum usi band diagram mein jaye, so if I will apply a voltage over here such that instead of this band bending that we had shown, okay, instead of this band bending, so I apply a voltage over here, so band bending ab ulti direction mein ho jaye. So what would happen? There would be more holes because Fermi level is now closer to the valence band. So when such a voltage is applied, we call that as accumulation mode. Okay, when the voltage is applied of the same order jaisa abhi humne is figure mein dekha tha originally, yes?
So I'm really sorry, but yeah, so band gap thing is really new to me, so I'm sorry for the basic doubts, but can you please explain how does applying, I mean, what is the effect of applying voltage? Like, can you give like some examples, like 1 volt, 2 volt, how would that work across the sweep of voltage ranges?
Yeah, so there is this MOS that we see, MOS capacitor that we see.
Yes, sir.
So I will apply some voltage across the gate and the substrate.
Yes, sir.
So what if I apply a voltage such that the gate,
yes, sir,
the gate over here goes up.
Yes, sir. That's how would it go up?
How would it go up? Because I've applied a voltage. This
okay,
is a metal,
so my
no?
this. Yeah.
So
yeah.
I apply a negative voltage here. Let us say.
Okay. So the whole
I
thing shifts up.
I apply a negative voltage here, and what happens is there is negative charge over here on the gate because I applied negative voltage. So it will attract holes.
Yes.
Holes will come closer to the surface.
Yeah.
In terms of the band diagram, this is how it will look.
Okay. Okay.
Okay. Now let us say I apply a positive voltage. So what will happen at a positive voltage? This will go down.
Okay.
This will go down means band bending would increase.
Yes, yes,
so
yes.
This will go like this. Okay. So I will be into deep inversion, strong inversion. So ek taraf accumulation hai, dusri taraf I have applied such a positive voltage there that all my electrons just accumulate or just, you know, collect at the surface of the oxide. This is called as inversion. Somewhere in between, we will have depletion. Okay. So accumulation, inversion, and in between them, we have depletion. And what is happening now? In this accumulation mode, if you change V by delta V, where will the change in charge occur? In this layer? Am I right? If I apply some delta V, where will the change in charge occur?
At the interface.
Oxide
at the interface. And I add oxide substrate interface. So the distance between my two metal plates is T ox, the oxide thickness. Am I right?
Yes.
Similarly, in the inversion layer also, because there is such high density of electrons over here, when I change delta V, this high density of electrons will either increase or reduce. So over here also, the change in charge will happen across T ox. But look at the case of depletion. In depletion, there is no high density of electrons anywhere. I actually have a semiconductor kind of a behavior. In fact, depletion layer does not have any mobile charges. It does not have any mobile carriers. This much we remember. Am I right?
Yes, sir.
Depletion layer does not have any mobile carriers. So when you will apply some delta V, what happens? The edge of the depletion width will either come closer to the surface or go farther away from the surface. Are you able to see this? Because there is no free mobile carriers available in the depletion layer, I do not have inversion layer yet. I do not have accumulation zone yet. So when I will apply more charge or less charge on the gate, what happens? This depletion layer either grows a bit or reduces a bit. Are you with me on this? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, in effect, the distance between the two plates where change of charge is happening is T ox plus W depth, the depletion width. So what is happening? Initially, in one case, there is less T ox, less spacing between the two plates. So I would have one capacitance. Finally, also inversion layer, I have one capacitance, but somewhere in between, I have a capacitance which is lower. Are you able to see this?
Why don't we have the lowest capacitance in terms of, in case of accumulation? In case of inversion, because my T ox plus W depth is largest.
No, because I have a huge number of mobile electrons over here. If I do not want some electron, some electrons will go away and dissolve into the substrate somewhere. सो इट्स लाइक आपने आपने इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक फील्डिंग देखी है? हैव यू स्टडीड अबाउट द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक फील्डिंग? कि अगर एक मेटल होगा तो उसके बाद उसके अंदर आपका इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड ट्रांसमिट नहीं होता.
यस सर.
हाँ, अगर गॉस दैट गॉश गॉश थ्योरम एंड एवरीथिंग, कि अगर आपका एक 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 मटेरियल है, मेटल है यहाँ पे, और उसको आपने एनक्लोज कर दिया एक और मेटालिक बॉक्स में, तो बाहर आप जो भी इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड वेरी करते रहो, दिस विल नॉट एक्सपीरियंस एनी ऑफ दोज इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड.
यस सर.
व्हाई डज दैट हैपन? बिकॉज मेटल्स आर सेट टू बी सी ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन्स, है ना? तो वो इलेक्ट्रॉन्स एक तरह से शील्ड कर देते हैं अंदर की चीज को. द सेम थिंग हैपन्स ओवर हेयर. देर आर सो मेनी इलेक्ट्रॉन्स हेयर दैट इट ऑलमोस्ट बिहेव लाइक अ मेटल. डिप्लीशन लेयर की विड्थ चेंज ही नहीं होती, दिस मेटल सिंपली डज इट. इसी मेटल के अंदर के कुछ इलेक्ट्रॉन्स आगे पीछे हो जाते हैं, दैट्स इट.
ओके, थैंक यू.
ठीक है, तो हमने कहा कि एक्युमुलेशन में कैपेसिटेंस ज्यादा है, इन्वर्जन में कैपेसिटेंस ज्यादा है, बट डिप्लीशन में कैपेसिटेंस कम है. आर यू विद मी?
यस सर.
ओके, सो व्हाट वी आर एसेंशियली सेइंग इज दैट इन एक्युमुलेशन माय कैपेसिटेंस इज हाई, in inversion my capacitance is high, and in between my capacitance would fall. This is the characterized value of your MOS capacitor. Your MOS capacitor has a varying capacitance over time, over VGS, over VG, you may say VGB. Okay, and at the edge of accumulation where you have that V flat band appearing, that is where your depletion layer starts to begin and your capacitance starts to fall. As soon as your inversion layer has formed, you say that now the inversion layer has formed, now I will move into the high capacitance zone again. So this is the point of V flat band and this is the point of threshold voltage. Threshold voltage can be defined as a point where inversion layer has been formed. Is this clear till here? Any questions? Yes,
sir. Sir, I had a question.
Yes,
sir. When we are moving from depletion to inversion, the like the electrons are gathering towards the plate. So shouldn't the transition be a gradual transition?
Yeah. So this is just a cartoon. This is just a cartoon. In reality, you will see that something like this would happen. So यहाँ तो बस आपको अंडरस्टैंडिंग देने के लिए मैंने इसको इतना स्टीप दे दिया है. एक्चुअल में इतना स्टीप नहीं होगा. एक्चुअल में आपका VT यहाँ कहीं होगा. ओके.
यस.
एनीथिंग एल्स? So now you will notice that in this curve there is this additional line which I have not talked about yet. What is this additional line about? Any ideas?
When we apply any high frequency voltage at the gate, then the charges of the substrate will not react according to that voltage and will not come to the channel region. Hence the capacitance is further low.
Okay. So what is being said is that when you will have very, very high frequency toggling at the gate, what high frequency? Let us say 10 gigahertz or 100 gigahertz. ठीक है, 100 gigahertz, 10 gigahertz में हम कितने picoseconds की बात कर रहे हैं? We're talking about, you know, 100 picoseconds. Actually 10 gigahertz नहीं, फिर 100 gigahertz मानते हैं. ठीक है, when you're talking about 100 gigahertz, what are we saying? 1 picosecond. है ना, 1 पिकोसेकंड और 10 पिकोसेकंड का टाइम है जिसके अंदर आपका जो इनपुट वोल्टेज है, वो ऐसे ट्रांजिशंस दे रहा है विद इन 10 पिकोसेकंड. नाउ आप अपने सेमीकंडक्टर को देखें. हमने कहा कि इन्वर्जन के दौरान, सो नाउ लेट अस लुक एट दिस फिगर. एक्चुअली In reality, to be able to bias the body, you will need to put a N plus region over here to bias the body. Am I right? But come whatever may, to bring some electrons over here in this inversion plate, what do we need? We need these electrons to transfer from this region physically into this region. And now at very, very high frequency, what has happened is the expected time in which you want this electron transfer to happen is not sufficient for actually moving electrons from here to here, from the substrate to the inversion layer. Utna time hai nahi. So kya hota hai? The change in electrons happens again at the depletion width boundary. Because depletion width boundary pe to आप बस 1 micron नहीं आगे पीछे ले जाओ तो इलेक्ट्रॉन्स आगे पीछे मूव कर गए. सो जस्ट जस्ट अ लिटिल बिट ऑफ मूवमेंट ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन्स ओवर हेयर वुड बी गुड इनफ. एंड सिंस द चार्ज मॉड्यूलेशन नाउ अगेन स्टार्ट्स टू हैपन एट द बाउंड्री ऑफ द डिप्लीशन विड्थ, योर कैपेसिटेंस इन हाई फ्रिक्वेंसी मोड्स रिमेन्स लो. And in intermediate frequencies, you will see it will be like this, somewhere in between. Okay. So the lower line is the high frequency response of the MOS capacitor. Okay.
Sir.
Yes.
Sir, could you please explain it again why the capacitance is less?
Okay, so to move a charge from the body terminal into the inversion layer, an electron needs to physically travel some distance. Is that part clear?
Yes, sir.
That time would depend on the electron speed that can happen in that material and the distance of the body terminal from your device, from the inversion region.
Yes, sir.
We just said that 100 gigahertz, I have only 10 picoseconds in which an electron has to come and also go back, because a full cycle happens between 10 picoseconds.
Hello, sir.
Yes, Naman.
Sir, sorry to interrupt. Why the electrons will go back? I mean,
because within 10 picoseconds, within 10 picoseconds, my signal has gone up and gone down.
Why now, we need N plus layer? In that you have said na ki wahan pe sir N plus.
Uspe aate hain. So within, pehle ye cheez samajh lo. Within 10 picoseconds, I have applied a positive voltage, so the electron will need to come. So the electron will need to come to the gate, and also a negative voltage, and electron has to go away from the gate. Within 10 picoseconds, this has to happen. So for coming to the gate and from taking it away, you have 5 picosecond reach. Itna part clear hai?
Yes, sir, it is clear.
So within 5 picoseconds, the electron has to come from wherever the body terminal is into the inversion layer. So wherever the body terminal is, if the body terminal was actually here, then from here to this place. But in reality, the body terminal will be somewhere. So आपका ये अगर ये आपका gate है, तो body terminal आप कहीं पे surface पे ही बनाओगे. Body को silicon को नीचे से तो आप connection नहीं दोगे ना, सारी pins silicon के ऊपर से ही आएंगी. तो body connected from the top only. So from here, for a electron to go into the inversion layer, it will require some time. That kind of time is not available because you have only 5 picoseconds. So electron cannot come from the substrate. Instead, electron exchange happens at the depletion width boundary. Because electron exchange is happening at the depletion width boundary, your effective spacing between the two plates is Tox plus W depletion. Therefore, your capacitance remains low. Is this clear now?
Yes, sir. And ये जो सर exchange हो रहा है electron का, this is basically recombination, right?
Yeah.
Okay, sir.
ठीक है. Generation and recombination basically. ठीक है. So that kind of brings us to a close of MOS capacitors. In the next class, we will look at the MOSFET operation, where you also have the source and the drain regions added. Okay, the MOS capacitor, this region we have already discussed. Now we will see the impact of adding source and drain, and what happens when you add source and drain to this material. Okay.
Hello, sir.
Yes.
Sir, sorry to disturb. Can I ask one question? Like, सर वहाँ पे n प्लस लेयर क्यों यूज हुआ था? वहाँ पे p प्लस होना चाहिए, क्योंकि बॉडी का यूज कर रहे हैं ना, बॉडी टर्मिनल दिखा रहे हैं, तो वहाँ पे p प्लस से शो करेंगे ना बॉडी टर्मिनल, लाइक p सबस्ट्रेट है तो. यस सर, इन थर्ड फिगर.
हाँ, यू आर राइट, दिस शुड बी p प्लस, दिस शुड बी p प्लस, यू आर राइट.
ओके,
ठीक है. So I'm not starting the MOSFET part today. We will start with MOSFETs in the next class, and we will talk about linear operation region, saturation region where the pinch off has occurred, and we will talk about the equations there and the concept of velocity saturation that we already mentioned in the last class, and how that, you know, long channel device and short channel device, how they behave differently. So we'll start to look into MOSFETs in the next class. Okay, so we will close the class now. It's almost time. If there are any questions, you can ask me, otherwise we'll close.
Sir, could you please go to the previous slide?
Sorry. Yeah.
Here they have written AC and DC in the, you know, bottom two diagrams.
Yeah.
What are they like exactly?
The AC and DC that is written over here. So what it's saying is that if you, okay, so this AC, when he says AC, he actually means this very high frequency signal where the change would happen at the end of the, at the edge of the depletion layer. The low frequency signals where my electrons can actually come from the substrate into the inversion layer, he is calling it as DC. That's it. Okay, this is just to represent that the change in depletion width or the other plate is here in DC and here in AC.
Sir, and one more thing, in the inversion, we can see that the cloud of charges are accumulated just below the COX. Mm-hmm. And also we have a capacitance formed because there's a depletion region below this cloud of electrons again. And yes, again we'll have charges. So can't we consider that as a capacitance again?
Yes, there is a capacitance again. But the overwhelming capacitance will still remain to be this, no? When you change anything at the gate voltage, charge change happens here. That is what is the definition of the capacitance for you. See, that was what we were looking at in the previous slide. That was why I discussed this before coming to that slide.
Okay, sir. Okay. So the effect on the gate side. Okay. Yeah. Got it.
Okay.
Sir.
Yes.
Sir, is there some resource or book in which like this thing is mentioned in a bit more detail as like we weren't exactly taught?
Every slide that I use, you will see that at the bottom of it, there will be a name of the book from which you can study more about that topic.
Sure, sir.
In fact, this topic you can also study from वेस्टे में भी दिया हुआ ये टॉपिक दो आई एम कवरिंग इट इन मच मोर डिटेल एंड आई एम कवरिंग इट फ्रॉम चू सी हू बट यू विल फाइंड दिस टॉपिक इन वेस्टे ऑल्सो यू विल फाइंड दिस टॉपिक इन रैबी ऑल्सो एंड यू विल फाइंड दिस टॉपिक इन सिविडिस ऑल्सो सो विच बुक आर यू यूजिंग फॉर एनालॉग सीमॉस कोर्स या रजावी में भी होगा ऑल एनालॉग सीमॉस बुक्स विल हैव दिस
हेलो सर
यस गुरुवीर
सर कुड यू मूव टू द नेक्स्ट स्लाइड
आई एम सॉरी
सर कैन यू मूव टू द नेक्स्ट स्लाइड सर
या
या सर इन डिप्लीशन हेलो
हाँ हाँ
सर इन डिप्लीशन पार्ट व्हेन वी इंक्रीज द गेट ओल्ड एज दिस डिप्लीशन विट विल इंक्रीज राइट
यस
Then how come we get Seox, sir? How will we get Seox?
So Seox will always there, na? The effective gate capacitance will be across Seox plus depletion width, which means your Seox and C depth will come in series. Therefore, if this capacitance is much lesser than this capacitance.
Sir, then for Seox, one plate is gate. What will be the next plate, sir, and another plate?
This one. See, the Seox has been shown differently than C-depth because the dielectric constant over here is different from the dielectric constant over here. That is why you have to necessarily consider it as two capacitances in parallel. Had the dielectric constant been same, we would have simply used one capacitance there.
Sir, then for C depth, what will be the next other plate? One plate is the this one border. Then what will be the next plate?
The interface, the oxide semiconductor interface.
Sir, then why can't we take that line for Cox also? I mean, for second plate.
Yes. So, sorry, you were asking. So that is it. CG has TOX plus W dip as the second, as the distance between two plates. COX has gate and interface only. Yes. I'm sorry. I thought that you were always asking about C gate. No. For the COX, these are the two plates because that is where you have this same dielectric. The dielectric has changed in the silicon. So you cannot have the COX across the silicon substrate.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
Okay.
Sir.
Yes.
Sir, one doubt from the cadence layout tool. Sir, you said that the black region is the p-type substrate. So suppose when we use the n-mos, sir, there why there is that additional np layer? I'm not able to understand. Sir, we must have oxide diffusion and polysilicon. Sir, is that layer just to identify us that this area belongs to n-mos?
The N plus layer is put so that you can dope the gate with N plus.
Sir, it's a physical layer or just a logical layer?
No, it is a physical CAD layer. It will get translated into a mask.
Okay.
So physical layer means it will get translated into a mask.
Yes.
Okay.
Okay. So the entire substrate is p-type, then we make a n plus region, then again we dope with the diffusion.
So the entire substrate is p-type, you may want to make a n-well for p-moses, and then you can have n-moses also, and on the gates of n-moses you will put n plus layer so that you can dope the gates.
Okay. So if we are building the NMOS right from the scratch, then also we need to use this NP, then active, then poly.
Yes.
Okay.
Whenever you make any device, you will use N plus or P plus.
Okay, sir.
Because the gate has to be doped.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now this isn't 65 nanometer technology. As I said, that we will have high K metal gate technologies when you will go to the industry, 7 FinFETs and 22 FinFET or 22 FD or 22 bulk, whatever. In those technologies, you may not have these N plus and P plus layer.
So then how we would distinguish that this area is for NMOS and this area is then for PMOS? Just
because
seeing
some
that
areas would have NVL, some areas would not have NVL.
Yes, sir. Yes. Okay.
Okay.
Yes, sir. Okay, got it.
Okay.
Sir? Sir?
Yes?
Could you explain what's the, use of using OD layer? Like, because we can always put a N plus on the source and drain, and would it not convert it into a physical?
No, that is not the purpose of N plus. The purpose of N plus is to dope the gate. Okay. OD layer is the layer used to define source and drain regions.
Okay.
Sir, okay. OD layer is the logical layer of that tool.
I'm sorry?
Sir, OD layer is the logical layer?
OD layer is a logical layer, yes. And it will also be used to dope the source and drain regions.
Sir, when we draw the structures, there is nothing like oxide diffusion in the structures of MOS.
So when we will look at the MOSFET in the next class, we will also see some perspective views. You will be able to see it then. Okay.
Okay,
sir. Yeah. Sir, आज के quiz के एक question था sir. सर उसमें जो मतलब wire width दिया था तो सर उसमें क्या मतलब वो barrier को include करके वो उस width को consider कर रहा था फिर बाद में हम लोग को
इमेज में दिया हुआ था ना इमेज जो दिखाई हुई थी उसमें W included the barrier in it.
ओके सर मतलब वहां से फिर मतलब बैरियर को x माइनस करके फिर वहां से वो
आपको क्रॉस सेक्शन निकालना था. यस yes.
अच्छा
ठीक है.
यस
या
सर एक और डाउट
है. यस
सर अनलाइक जब किसी वायर की सर रेजिस्टिविटी को कैलकुलेट करेंगे तो सर जैसे अभी केस में तो हमारे पास रेजिस्टिविटी उसकी नहीं थी सर जो बैरियर थी लेकिन सर वैसे हम बैरियर रेजिस्टिविटी को भी अकाउंट में लेते हैं.
दोबारा से बोलो सॉरी अक्षत.
सर जैसे एक्चुअल केस में सर जैसे मेटल होगा और उसके चारों तरफ बैरियर होगा प्रैक्टिकल केस में तो सर जब हम जैसे आपने एक पॉइंट लास्ट क्लास में बताया था कि सर जो टेंपरेचर कोफिशिएंट ऑफ रेजिस्टेंस होता है वो हमारा सर बैरियर के लिए बहुत ज्यादा होता है तो सर इसका मुझे मतलब थोड़ा सा वो सर क्लियर नहीं हुआ थॉट नहीं क्लियर हुआ सर मतलब इस बात का
थर्मल कोफिशिएंट द थर्मल द रेजिस्टिविटी थर्मल कोफिशिएंट ऑफ द बैरियर इज मच हायर देन दैट ऑफ मेटल. तो अगर आप एक मटेरियल मानो अगर आप इसको एक कॉम्पोजिट मटेरियल मानो तो आप ये जानोगे कि इसके अंदर 10% ऑफ द मटेरियल इज बैरियर एंड 80% या 90% इज मेटल. सो योर इफेक्टिव थर्मल कोफिशिएंट विल बी डिफरेंट.
ओके सर जब हम प्रैक्टिकल कैलकुलेशन करेंगे तो जो एक्चुअल रेजिस्टिविटी होगी हमारी मेटल लाइन की उसमें बैरियर की रेजिस्टिविटी भी इंक्लूड
होगी. यस यस
बट इट इज नॉट एप्लीकेबल टू द क्वेश्चन गिवन.
या वी हैव नॉट आस्क्ड यू दिस इन दिस वन. दिस वाज अ सिंपल क्वेश्चन.
सर करेक्ट मी इफ आई एम रॉन्ग सर जो एनमॉस है उसमें एनपी लेयर इस वजह से यूज कर रहे हैं क्योंकि गेट एन प्लस पॉलीसिलिकॉन है इसकी डोपिंग की वजह से एनपी लेयर होनी चाहिए एनमॉस में.
यस
और पीमॉस में पीपी लेयर इसी वजह से क्योंकि वो पी प्लस पॉलीसिलिकॉन का गेट है.
यस
अगर सपोज गेट हम लोग दूसरा जैसे सर आपने हाई के मटेरियल बताया तो इस वजह से वो लेयर हट जाती है और सिर्फ पीमॉस में एनवेल बचता है और एनमॉस में नहीं बचेगा.
यस
ओके ओके थैंक यू सर.
ठीक है चलो थैंक यू ऑल द बेस्ट. यस यस प्रखर
सर एक्चुअली वी वांटेड टू डिस्कस यू समथिंग दिस ओके सो कैन यू वेट फॉर 5 मिनट्स.
श्योर सो आई लेट द क्लास लीव.
यस सर
आई एम स्टॉपिंग द रिकॉर्डिंग.
Yes.
Yeah, I'm stopping the recording.